Think of the great moments where humanity has come together and we have achieved amazing moments. This is not a country going to the moon, this is a world coming together to solve a global crisis that will affect everyone. In its heart, it is a simple question. Can regenerative agriculture feed the world? And the answer is yes. The scientific bodies agree our current one will not work with a growing population. Humanity is complex and our food systems are complex, and it is a hard and trying transition to make. But it is one based on better outcomes for everyone. Hi, I'm Alexander Gillett, and I am the co-founder and the CEO of HowGood. I grew up in a lot of countries. When I was living in the Maharashtra Valley of India, I got my first real experience into the production of food and the way that it impacted people's lives. The scale and the reach of our food system has stayed very present in how I think about the world. Conventional agriculture is the cause for 30% of global carbon. And in a system that could actually be sequestering carbon, that just shows you how backwards and disrupted our food system is. The UN has said we have till 2050 before we have a complete collapse of the majority of our agricultural land because of the degradation of soil. If we do not switch to a regenerative agricultural system, we will be in trouble as a species and as a planet. So we have to improve the food system. We've brought together the largest database on carbon, biodiversity, and labor impacts of the food system to measure their impact. We have the largest distributors in the world, the largest CPGs in the world, the largest grocers in the world, all a part of it. The data set is just truly unique and helps the people on the ground know what their impact is and also see the path to be able to fix the system. So we notice an enormous amount of data inaccuracies within a lot of the current systems that are being used. Normally it's due to oversimplification. When you're looking at a large-scale system like this, the quality of the data is paramount. We're looking at greenhouse gas emissions, biodiversity impacts, water, we're looking at soil health. We want to take that nerdy data workload off the plates of every individual company and make it their job to fix exactly what's happening on the ground. The data's available. It's not expensive, it's easy to access. There's a million different steps that are laid out, but most of these are influenced by data. We can take that data now and you can give it to the businesses that are trying to make these transitions. When bonus structures are set on lower carbon and greater biodiversity, that has a measurable impact on how quickly these get implemented at scale globally. And then countries on top of that can also create regulations and tracking that help support that entire shift. Sustainable, it's a midway point. It means that things are gonna stay the same. And regenerative is just the other end of the scale. It means things are improving. Businesses are a key component in making this shift. When business started to show up, government started to take it more seriously. They're finding solutions, companies starting to scale up their solutions and make commitments, and that's groundbreaking. And each one of those pieces where we create more transparency and normalcy, the bigger and bigger impact it'll have. The barriers to creating a comprehensive, you know, regenerative framework is really across every single different level. But for the vast majority of food products, the hotspot for the vast production of carbon is at the farm level. The inputs, the pesticides and the fertilizers and the fungicides, the different farming methodologies, so all of these pieces impacted, and there's no silver bullet. If we solve carbon, but we decimate biodiversity, our food system will still drop off. If we solve carbon and biodiversity, but we create, you know, human atrocities, it's not a just system and it's not a worthwhile endeavor. So we have to work within that natural framework to actually create a better, more holistic system for everyone. When you're switching from a conventional practice to a regenerative practice, you have a 5-year dip where there's actually a fall off in yield. So we have to do what we call filling the dip. And so it's pivotal that within each of these systems, that they're starting to reward these changes. There's an enormous number of financial opportunities for farmers who are looking to make this shift. They're different in every country. They're different with different crops. A lot of companies are trying to also support this by committing to buying those crops once they are regenerative and at a better price point from one farm to another, from one purchaser of those ingredients to another, all the way up the supply chain and all the way down the supply chain. Companies are able to certify for regenerative practices. And every consumer in the world going to purchase a good has to stand behind the values and the world they want to live in. We're looking at it as a holistic system, and we're moving towards a unified understanding. There is no question, if we do not switch to a regenerative agricultural system, we will be in trouble as a species and as a planet. So we have to improve the food system. It's not can we, it's will we, and that's all of our responsibility.